नमस्ते, आई देवेन गौरवल फ्रॉम द फैकल्टी ऑफ फिजिकल एंड डायग्नोस्टिक एफपीडी इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ डायग्नोस्टिक एंड रेमेडी हेल्थ इन द डिसिप्लिन रेडियोलॉजी वर्किंग इन देवी वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ डिस्कशन ऑफ मैग्नेटिक रेजोनेंस इमेजिंग in that is included in the post hospital administration in radio diagnosis in ECRT system. Next, we discuss about the magnetic resonance imaging. It is purely based on the NMR, NMR nuclear magnetic resonance. It is the principle of the magnetic resonance imaging. MRI is a test that uses powerful magnets, radio waves, and a computer to make detailed pictures of the inside of your body, inside of a patient body. The doctor can use this test to diagnose the patient, or to see how well the patients are responded to treatment. Okay, so they use to know about or to diagnose a patient and how the patient is responded to the treatment. It is also be clear in the MRI test, unlike the X-ray and computed tomography CT scan. The MRI don't use the harmful ionizing radiation of X-ray. The uses of MRI and MRI magnetic resonance imaging helps a doctor to diagnose a disease or injury, and it can monitor how well the patients are doing with the treatment. MRI can be done on different part of the patient body. It's especially useful for looking at soft tissue and the nervous system. So the dense for diagnose the dense matter or dense material in the human body, like bony cavities, like thoracic cavity and brain, in case of brain, in case of thoracic cavity, there is a cavity that is surrounded by the bones. So bone can't be detected in the MRI through the MRI, but MRI can detect a disease in the soft tissue and a nervous system or brain, and MRI of the brain and the spinal cord can help find many things, including first one is the blood vessels, damage. Second is the brain injury, that is the cancer. Okay, it is used to diagnose a tumor or cancer. Okay, any brain injury, any blood vessel damage like blood vessel rupture or vessel, any injury in the vessel, any leakage, any obstruction, any type of embolism. Okay, multiple sclerosis. Okay, spinal cord injury, any injury in the spinal cord, stroke, eye problem that is related to the brain, inner ear problem. Okay, so an MRI of heart and blood vessels looks like. So MRI of heart of blood vessels. The use of the MRI heart and blood vessels are: first one is the blocked blood vessels, second one is the damage caused by a heart attack. Okay, so it can evaluate or it can detect the blood vessels that is a blocked or damaged caused by the heart attack, any heart disease related to valve, related to chamber, related to any other obstruction problems with the structure of the heart, and MRI of the bones and joints looks for both infection, cancer, okay, damage to the joints, disc problem in the spine, neck or low back pain with nerve sign. So MRI can detect the bone deformity like one infection, any infection in the bone, any cancer or tumor, any damage to the joints, okay, any type of disc problem in the spine, okay, neck or low back pain. Okay, these are the MRI indications in respect to the bones. Okay. So in this session, we had discussed about the uses of MRI and uses of MRI. So MRI is also a technique of a radiology technique. It uses magnetism, a radio wave and a computer to produce an image of a body structure. MRI is based on the principle NMR nuclear magnetic resonance. Okay. What can be diagnosed by MRI? Okay. The cases or disadvantage in which the MRI is contraindicated or it has a disadvantage of MRI imaging. First one is the cardiac pacemaker. In the case of cardiac pacemaker, if a cardiac pacemaker is placed in the heart, then it is contraindicated. Central second is certain clips in your head from the brain operation, a cochlear implant, a metallic foreign body in your eye. In the patient's eye, head surgery in last 8 weeks, then MRI investigation is contraindicated if the patient are pregnant. MRI makes use of magnetic properties, certain atomic nuclei, hydrogen nuclei, single proton present in water molecules and therefore in all body tissues. A hydrogen nuclei partially aligned by a strong magnetic field in the skin. Okay. So this session. In this session, we are going to discuss about the ultrasonography principle applications. The applications of ultrasonography is in four parts. Like first one is the thoracic application, transthoracic application. Second one is the abdominal application. Next one, musculoskeletal application or head USG application in infants. Okay. So first, thoracic transthoracic application is chest wall. Like pleural lesion. Pleural means the cavity that is present in around the lung. Okay. Third one is the peripheral lung nodules. Okay. Fourth is the pulmonary consolidation and lungs axis, mediastinal masses. Okay. peridiaphragmatic lesion means the lesion that is present around the diaphragm. Diaphragm, peridiaphragmatic lesion. Okay. So in this pleural lesion and peripheral lung nodule. Next one is the abdominal application. Abdominal applications in the abdominal application, the first one is abdominal pain or distension. It the ultrasonography is used for the abdominal pain in the full abdomen. Second one is the abnormal liver function. If the the liver function is affected, then it is performed to investigate the abdominal liver function. Enlargement or enlarged abdominal organ like liver, fatty liver, or enlarged liver, or the size that is affected in any disease. Fourth one is stone in the gallbladder and kidney. Kidney means it is performed for renal calculus or any type of calculus present in the abdominal lesion like urethra or any other lesion. Or stone in the gallbladder. Gallbladder means poly. In the gallbladder stone. Next one is the musculoskeletal application. Musculoskeletal application is tendon tear, means it is present in the tear or tear present in the tendon. Okay. Next one is the ligament sprain or tear. Okay. Ligament sprain. Okay. Third one is early change of rheumatoid arthritis. Okay. Fourth one is dislocation of the hip in the infant. Okay. Dislocation in that is seen in the infect benign or malignant soft tissue tumor. So it is used for any tear in the tendon or ligament or any early sign of the rheumatoid arthritis. That is the inflammation in the joint. Okay. Last application in it is used in the head here. Okay. Head usually generally head usually not performed because the head of brain is covered with the mostly covered with the bony part. Okay. So it is used to evaluate for hydrocephalus or enlargement of the ventricles. Second, evaluate the intraventricular hemorrhage. Okay. When we have periventricular leukomalacia, evaluate the congenital abnormalities. Okay, congenital abnormalities that is present in the tissue of the baby. Okay, so we can evaluate through any USG. So I think this session is very much helpful for to know about the to know or increase the knowledge about the USG. Okay, so. In this session, we have discussed about the USG application, ultrasonography application in the abdomen, in the thoracic region, in the head region, okay? In musculoskeletal. Okay. In the previous session, we have discussed about the sonography. Sonography is a sonography imaging technique that is used for investigation to investigate the internal structure of the body by using high frequency sound waves. How the high frequency sound goes, that is the ultrasound, ultrasonography or ultrasound. Okay. So, the frequency range are used, that is used in the diagnostic radiology, 1 MHz to 20 MHz. Okay. Or it depends, the frequency of the sound depends on the nature of medium like medium is solid or medium is liquid or gaseous. So the velocity of the ultrasound wave in the soft tissue is 1540 meter per second. So it is based on the principle of piezoelectric effect. Piezoelectric effect means when electric current is applied on the USG region in the USG transducer, after exciting the electric current, it generates a pressure wave. Pressure wave that produces sound wave. Okay, so in the electric current excitation, the sound wave are generated, then it is called piezoelectric effect. Okay, in this session we have discussed about the basic principle of USG and the application of USG and what is USG, why the USG is used. Okay. So, then the USG is in the transmitter, a system that is used for the production of the sound waves, high frequency sound waves, is the piezoelectric crystal that is made up of lead zirconium titanium. So I think this session is very much useful for you to know about the ultrasonography and the application. Okay. Thank you. This session is over. I think you all satisfied with the session. If you have any query, then put it into the comment box. I will resolve it later. Thank you. This session is powered by Distribution 2.0. Stay with me.